Hey everybody, I'm Lance Goyke. Today I want to discuss some fundamental movements. So when I get a new client in, I like to take them through four different movements, and these are just some variation of fundamental movements, our fundamental movement patterns. So first off is a squat. There's a lot of knee bend, the butt drops straight down, and you feel your quads burning a lot when you do that. Second fundamental movement is the bend or the deadlift. So this is more of a hip dominant exercise. My knees don't bend quite as much. They only bend to allow me to get some mobility, but what I'm primarily training here are my hamstrings and my glutes. Switching to the upper body now, we have an upper body push, like a push-up or like a bench press or like an overhead press. These are some of our more fundamental pushing away from me patterns. And then we have the upper body pull, the row, the pull-up. Let me see if I can get good scapular movement that allows my shoulder to move, transmit force, and not get injured. Biggest things on the deadlift are I need to make sure that I'm driving with those target muscles. I need to make sure I'm using hamstrings and glutes. With the squat, the biggest thing that I need to pay attention to is, am I not turning it into a deadlift? I don't want to be bending over too much during my squat. I want to allow some knee bend as long as my knees can tolerate it. And I want to make sure I keep my nice base of support. I want my feet to stay flat in the ground and I want to drive through my heel. That will still allow me to recruit the quad to do this exercise. And you know, you'll feel some hamstring and some glute as well. With my upper body push, especially the push-up is probably the best example of this. That's what I like to use for most people on their first day, if I think they can do some inclined push-ups pretty well. The issue here is I need to make sure that I get my push, but I need to also make sure that my shoulder blades can spread apart and wrap around my body. This rounds my upper back in a normal way. It's supposed to be that way, right? And so this exercise, a push-up with that nice little extra push at the top, reinstates that normal posture for you. So that is very necessary. In terms of a upper body vertical push, like an overhead press or something, I need to make sure that you have the requisite mobility to get your arms up there even without weight, because otherwise I know you're not going to be able to do it. And two, I need to make sure that your shoulder blades are moving as your arms are moving. So there should be about 2.4 degrees of motion in your shoulder joint for every 1 degree of motion in your shoulder blade itself. So they both play, you know, very significant roles in reaching your arms up overhead. Now, last two here are upper body rows. I need to make sure that I'm leading with my shoulder blade. I need to make sure that I'm giving the shoulder room to do its exercise. And I need to make sure that I'm using the shoulder blade muscles to do this stuff. It's not just about low back muscles. It's not just about lats. It's not just about arms. I primarily want to drive these motions with the upper back musculature. Now, it's not that bad to have lats, to have arms, but I need to make sure that I'm getting the muscles between your shoulder blades as well. And lastly, a vertical pull. It's the same idea. All these upper body motions require the right scapular movement in relation to the upper arm movement, the humerus movement. So with a pull up, it's just the reverse of a overhead press. And so when I get to the top of my pull up, I can let my arm let me show you while I do it. I can let my arm hang like this and get a little longer. But the first movement when I'm getting ready to pull, I don't want to do it while my shoulder is up like that. I want to make sure I set my shoulder down and then I can start pulling. That will again help me get some of those muscles between the shoulder blades, get a nice rotation of the shoulder blades while I squeeze my lats and my arm muscles that we already talked about. So when you're writing a program, you want to make sure you're addressing all of these fundamental movements. There are some times where I won't include a single variation. Like if somebody's really bad with their upper body posture, I might not give them any rows because people really mess those up. But you know, pretty much everybody needs all of these variations. You need a squat, you need a bend, you need a push, you need a pull, okay? Make sure you're training those. Make sure you're keeping that in mind while you write a program. If you've got someone who's just looking for general fitness, like most people are, who's only willing to work out twice a week, like most people are, then you might pair an upper and a lower body exercise together. So I squat, and then while my legs are resting, I'm going to do a push-up, and then back and forth and back and forth. And I can train those movements and use one of the movements to kind of let the other muscles recover. And it helps me get more work done in less time, which is really great when somebody is only willing to work out twice a week and not really get any results. And then my other day would be like a bend deadlift variation and some sort of pulling variation. Yeah, I think that is very important to understand. So that's fundamental movements in writing your programs.